Hello everyone, this is part 7 of my Byzantium Civ 5 game. This is turn 723. Now, I don't actually remember exactly what I was doing prior to the cut here. It's been a couple of days since I recorded the previous part. But I should be able to pick it up pretty quickly along the way here. Okay, so I was doing a late game expansion push here into less than ideal terrain there, but I was looking for basically more cultural and tourism sources there. It looks like it'd be a good idea to dump another city somewhere around here. Yeah, here I would be able to. But that's about the only place that would make any sense in there. I may just go ahead and do that. Okay. What is this? Why do I have the great prophet sleeping? You know what? I think I was going to plant him there. I must have miscued with a click or something. Right, so I definitely want to get my culture production up. Now, of course, the number of cities I've got is impacting that. My faith production is pretty solid. Let's see. I really want these cities to go to pick up my religion here. I may have to break down and go for a missionary to do that. I may actually do that. Actually, I should check. Did I build my buildings in here? No. I should do that. You know, that gives me happiness in the empire and also culture and faith, so it's definitely worth doing. So I built city walls here. There is a decent spot for a city down here. So I might go ahead and do that. Yeah, right about here would be a decent spot. So, I'm actually going to do that. No, that's not what I want. Click on the right things, you idiot. Right. So, I want a settler. I'll build a castle here. So I'm working on building my defensive buildings as well. I suspect there's a good chance I'll end up with a fight on my hands. I always suspect that, even if it doesn't materialize. Right, so what, where did I say I thought this the good spot was? It was here, right? One, two, three. Yeah, it was there. So I'm gonna. Okay, good. There's no barbarian there. That means somebody else cleared it. That's good. So if I put my city in there, I have a chance at this stone resource. And if I wanted to, I could steal this with a great general. Now, if I'm going to build a city down there, I should. Start working on a road into there. Now, I was just reading this morning that Civilization 6 is scheduled for a fall release. So that'll be interesting to see what they change. And even more interesting will be to see if they have a Linux version of the game at release time. That'd be really nice. Do I want to do it there? Or do I want to go up one here? Actually, I want to go. No. Yeah. I want to go up that one more tile there. Yeah, that's definitely what I want to do with that. Okay, caravans, right. Okay, and this one I was sending production to my capital. So I'll build my city there. Now, I've got my empire in an unhappy state, which is obviously not something that I want to continue. But it will be fine for the time being. Okay, so that's that. Okay, I've accessed the iron there. Right. Shrine. Now for a monument there. Now, something I can do. Oh, wait. Policy time. Right. This one opens up for great engineers. If I complete this, I get culture from holy sites. Actually, yeah, I want to complete that one. Because that allows me to purchase great engineers. And I find great engineers are more useful than the other possible great people for the most part. They allow you to hurry wonders, you see. Right. Now what here? One thing, if you build your cities closer than the 7 tile distance, 6 tile gap, you don't have any bits where you, due to the lay of the land or whatever, where you don't have the terrain under production. But that doesn't necessarily give you any huge benefits. Wait, what's this? That's plains, okay. That's a zoo, so that was happiness. Yeah, walls for defense. And we got a cities gone religious. So I'll put the buildings in. So even though there isn't really a good payoff in terms of the faith cost of building those buildings, the culture and tourism and happiness from them makes it worth it. Ah, right. What have we got here? Oh, okay, yeah, that's worth building. I was actually doing an experiment with another mod, which removes the build time penalty for buildings and so on in the Marathon game, so. You basically get a longer game, but with the same dynamics as the regular pace game. Now, it was interesting for a bit, but there were some other impacts to it that I'm not sure were beneficial. That is, you end up with your units and stuff out so soon, and things improved so quickly that you really don't have anything doing. Okay, I can build my buildings in here too, except I don't have enough faith. Right. Okay, so I'll have the faith real quick at 120 faith per turn. Which is pretty decent. Faith is one thing that you end up with a much better production of when you start doing the crazy city spamming techniques simply because the faith generation is essentially tied to the number of cities. I need to build some roads up there, but yeah, I think I'm okay there, so I should build the roads. So I'm gonna ultimately want a road across there and along the coast. Yeah, that's what I'll do. So I'll move my artist here out of the way. I'm saving the artist to until I get a second one so I can have two from the same era. Right, so I'll just send that guy over there. These mountains are actually quite a barrier. I've got a pass here. There's a pass here. that the Arabs have, and there's the coastal route past them, but otherwise they're a pretty solid barrier. Okay, so my religion spread, that's good. Right, so I want to get my religious buildings out before somebody else's religion comes in and clobbers the ability to build them. Right. What was I? That was a Right, I was building a road there, so I'll keep on going. I won't need any other road connections into was it Sardica? Sardica? Whatever the. I don't know how you pronounce half these city names. I could, of course, just pick my own city names, but that's just a pain. Right. Oh, right. I'm reestablishing a caravan there. And I'm working on my coastal road there. Anyway, I was experimenting with a marathon game with standard build speed. And one of the things that was there is the religion costs, like the faith cost for religion, was substantially reduced. So basically, the game moves quite a lot faster, except for it still takes longer to do research and all of that stuff. Right. Ormus. Okay, so I'll send my great merchant out to do a trade mission there. And oh, need to take care of some barbarians here. Okay, that was a castle there. What do I actually want here? Well, I'll build a trebuchet for defending my new city down there. That's a good way to keep the pointiest sticks ranking up. And if you have it high enough, then the other civilizations tend not to invade. Oh, look, another city became religious. Okay, so I'm going to take this guy out eventually, but he needs to get close enough that I can whack him with the city. Okay. Okay, I'll conduct my trade mission. That gets me a stack of gold and influence there. And with that gold, I can come down here. And get a boost here as well. It also means I can acquire the settler to fill in this gap that I wanted to fill in. I think it was here that I was going to put the city. So I'm going to do that. Now, of course, I'm going to have to wait until I clear that bloody encampment, which I can do. by sending that guy out. Actually, can send the settler out with him. Oh, good. I can deal with that now. Let that let that guy heal. Right. So if I come around this way, then I can send the settler off that way. And I don't have a chance of him being intercepted by the barbarian. So I'll do that. Okay, so need to improve some resources here. Actually, one, two, that one's out of range. I know there's some other. Yeah, I'll send him. Send it over here. I knew there was something that was worth improving. And I can't get across around in into that lake, so or I guess inland sea. So I'll have to just leave that unimproved. Though it would be, now it's not a big loss. I've already got crabs, so it wouldn't help the happiness. Walls, okay, castle. What have I? Okay, walls is good. There is a. I think there's a an ideological tenet that gives happiness from walls and so on. It might actually be. It might actually be. A policy, I can't remember. Okay, that's cleared. Good. And I was putting this here. Down here would seem like a good spot as well. Huh. What's over here? That's defensible and it's on a river. You know, that probably makes more sense. Okay, so that's a wonder completed there. Now I've got other things going on here. Okay, so I'll catch up on buildings there. Yeah, it's a granary, so that'll improve growth speed. Zoo would be happiness. Harbor or a garden. I'm going to go with the zoo first, as that will go a long way to offsetting the unhappiness cost for my new city. Anyway, oh, right. I can buy my buildings here now. So that's actually a pretty solid tourism number for turn 749. So that gives you a fair idea how good the city spamming thing can be if you're going for a cultural victory. As it allows you to get a large cultural tally per turn, which defends against the other guy's tourism. So I've got a bunch of cities with four, but now there's these guys with 10 or 14 that are improving on that are getting more going on. Right, so I'll plant the city here. And okay. I'll continue on there. Oh, my roads are accumulating. That's good. And shrine. I'm probably going to get a don't settle near me. Yep. Since I'm not planning to make more cities in the immediate future, seems reasonable that I'll just say, yeah, I'll refrain from doing that. Yeah, I'm gonna need to get some workers out here. Okay, metallurgy, Red Fort. Okay. Okay. So I'll send my new trebuchet to its home. Roads. What have I got here? That's a farm. Okay, so I'll come in here and start improving around this guy. Right. Astronomy allows me to build observatory. Banking gives Forbidden Palace. I'm going to research banking. As it has other benefits as well, like banks. Right. I finished a trebuchet. You know what? I'm going to build some more trebuchets for my other new cities. I'm going to switch to the Red Fort. Now, what's the Red Fort do? That makes defensive buildings more effective. Great scientist points, even. So that's kind of good. Actually, how are great people doing? Great artist, some time off. Great engineer, some time off. Merchant, some time off. Everything. Oh, there's a writer coming up real soon now. Okay. Okay, so I've got my trebuchet there. And as usual, I'm not going to participate in somebody else's war. I'm just going to defend my territory. Okay, what if I. Okay, that's a stable there. Yeah, I think a zoo is a good idea there. Right. Okay, so I'm not really competing religion-wise here. It looks like Attila didn't get a religion. It looks like the Arabs didn't either. Okay. Okay, what, the nice thing about the walls and the castles, they don't have any maintenance cost. Okay, so that was a shrine. I'll get the monument out. The culture cost of new policies goes up fast enough that having the city spamming method going on actually handicaps your culture generation and your policy adoption to a large extent. So it's a calculated risk when you do that. So what I want to do is I want to get a workshop in these two cities, so that I can send production back to Constantinople. I'm continuing my road building mission there. Okay, there's a trebuchet. So I'll send it off to its new home. I'll keep building trebuchets until I have one in every city. there. The reason I'm doing trebuchets is because they upgrade to ultimately to rocket artilleries, which give you a better range. That's why I didn't stock all my cities with archers or crossbowmen early on, because they eventually come along and they upgrade to a machine gun, which gets one range instead of two. So it's really a downgrade. Where am I here? Okay, I've got enough. I've built my buildings there. Wait a minute. I've built them there. So I'll build them here. So I have two more cities to stock with my religious buildings. And it's a great writer. A treatise gets me a lot closer to the next one. I'm going to wait a couple of turns, as I've just increased my culture, so waiting with that get me a little bit more. So as I was going to put a workshop. So I'll start building those. What I wanted to know, okay, that is 2373. Let's see if it makes any substantial difference to wait another turn or two. Yeah, it's making a decent difference, so I'll wait on that. Okay, we have a swordsman there. I'll clear that guy out. Oh, somebody. Yeah, we'll accept that. The few gold coins will make a difference. Oh, we got a promotion there. Next turn, that guy will be gone unless he spawn the camp spawns. Right, 2463. So that is still increasing. Okay, that's good. If I go park that guy there, that saves me some gold. Now, right. 2508. It's still making a decent increase. Okay. Right, caravan. What to research? Architecture. Or astronomy. Architecture. Right. Production. That's a shrine, right. So now I want a monument there. Okay. And what was this one at? 2508. $25.53. So yeah, it's still substantial. Okay, we've established a city connection. This is useful. Right. Park that one. Right. Now, where did I buy the buildings? It was there. So here's my next step. So I'll do that. That actually clears the empire being unhappy, which is helpful. So this is where the pagodas and mosques are really, really helpful. It can, if you're doing the city sprawl spam thing. Right, so that is farm the hill there. 2604, still much better. You know what? I need some workers out, so I'm going to build a worker there. At the very least, I need to repair these. That's still growing. See, I'm not going to get the culture policy or the social policy any faster if I plant the great writer, if I, you know, consume him now. So I might as well wait on that. Okay, that's another trebuchet. Send it up to its new home. 2715. Okay. I still need a couple more trebuchets, so I'll do that. And that was a monument. So I'll build a workshop. At the very least, it'll get my next things out sooner. Do I have? Yeah. Good. 2730. Okay, the increase is reducing. So a road there, another road chunk there, and I'll have a city connection there. And my empire has gone unhappy again. That means a bunch of cities grew in size. But that will sort out soonish. Yeah, that's only increasing by 15 per turn now. So I'm actually going to bulb him now. And social policies. I want to go there, but I'm going to open this as it'll keep my influence with city-states longer. Now, out of curiosity, yeah, somebody else has built the Forbidden Palace, but can't remember who. Least I think somebody else has built it. Yep, that seems reasonable. Okay, I can buy another building. I'll do that. And then I've got two more to pick up here. Okay, good. That trebuchet has arrived. So I need three more trebuchets. So I'm going to queue them up. Add to queue. Trebuchet, trebuchet. Okay, park that one. Good, moving along. So now I'm basically consolidating everything. Getting these cities up to a proper production state. Right, okay, what I've finished a castle here. So, bank, yes. That's a monument completed there. Yeah, workshop I think would be a good idea. Right. So I'll get that worker out. I'm going to build another one. So I've got a stack of cities where I've got to improve stuff around them, so I'll get that going. Okay, this coming turn, I'll be able to build another building. There's the Red Fort. Right, this was where. As I built both of them here, yes. So those ones, these cities, when they get up to size 3, aren't going to contribute on happiness because of the fact that the buildings can only provide as much happiness as there are citizens in the city. Right. Zoo would, yeah, complete the zoo there. That's a trebuchet. Send that one where it's going. Right. Okay, there isn't much more I can build over there, but I can improve stuff over here. So I'll do that. And that's a road going in there. Fix that improvement. Right, moving along. Yeah, I think it's a good idea to upgrade those. Do I have another one of those around? I do. Right, good. Oh, that's a cargo ship. Right. So I definitely need to do something about this unhappiness I've got going along, this low level of it. So the next social policy will go a long way to that, but that's a long way off. 49 turns. So that's a monument there. Workshop's going to take forever. I'm going to build the shrine there. Right, I gotta park those. Okay. stone. I should actually improve that. Since my Pantheon belief gives me faith from quarries, might as well do that. And also, that's giving me production over in Sardica here. Yeah, I'll have a zoo in Constantinople in a couple of turns. That'll be good. Next turn, I think I get the I finish off my religious buildings, so that'll be good. That's quite a lot of tourism, considering I don't think I have any great works. I don't. So that's a lot of tourism you can get for no great works. Right. Okay. Right. Get my C improvements out there. And over here. There we go. That should be all of those. So, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I have 11 cities at 4 tour. Yep, that's all of them. Okay, that's improved. Now I need to improve or fixed. I need to fix that one. Redo that. Right, production's finished there. Opera House. Yeah. Okay, that's okay, that I should build a quarry there. I'm gonna put a bank there now. I don't want my gold to go negative. I definitely want to keep the gold production going. I got a city connection established here. Oh, right, okay, so that guy has arrived. And there's another trebuchet. which I can send there. And I'll keep on building my coastal road there. So I have one more trebuchet to get out, and then I'll turn that city back to other more useful improvements. Huh, the happiness in the empire is up. So a road there. No, I think that's from the city connection, actually. Right, so I don't have anything to purchase with faith at this point in time, so... Okay, that's a harbor there. I'm going to go for the garden, because I kind of want my great people to show up faster. Build the quarry there. And I guess I want to improve the horses there. And these resources here. But nothing critical there. Okay. Okay, science. Right. What is my tech tree looking like? Industrialization, I think, is where I want to get to. Or maybe archaeology. No, industrialization first, then archaeology. Okay. So I want to get to an ideology first. I want the freedom ideology, and I want to get there first. So. So I'm going to finish the garden in Constantinople and then get it going on something else, and then I'll call it apart here. So that's what, three turns. Okay, good. I'll send him up there for the horses. Embargo city-states, huh? So I'm doing pretty good culture-wise there. Okay. I'll make a pasture on the horses there. And then I'll send that worker over there, if I remember for the next part. Right. Okay, that'll be fine. Okay. So now I'll build the Taj Mahal, because that's a nice one. It starts a golden age, as I'm just about going to hit unhappiness again. And the nice thing about a golden age is, well, things do better. Right. So that's that. I'm going to call that the end of part 7, I think it is. And I'll see everybody back for part 8.